in the tunnel after the last game, things got real.
We did some good things tonight, but not enough to get the W. That's the way it goes sometimes. What you think?
I think some of us did our part and others didn't.
What you trying to say? You did your part and the rest of us was messing around?
You don't really want me to answer that honestly, do you? But you know what? I've had enough of the way you've been talking to me, man, so check the box score.
Maybe you should go check the box scores, because I swear the problem wasn't me. I did what I was supposed to do. Maybe somebody else should be looking in the mirror.
I look in the mirror every day, and I like what I see. Man, should try it sometime.
Hey, I did what I had to do to win.
Well, obviously, it wasn't enough, was it?
Hey, listen, go check the film, okay? Because I did my part. How about you? Go check yourself.
Now, that tension's been brewing for a while, so I had to get that out. But I also had to meet with the coach later that same week.
What are you smiling about?
Life's good. I'm hitting my stride right now. I'm just happy to be balling.
That's why I called you in here. You have been balling. If you keep producing like this, I see no reason why you won't be in the starting lineup before long. We always try to be careful with the new guys, make sure they fit our system the way we want them to. But it seems like just a matter of time for you. How does that sound?
That sounds good to me, Coach. I'll do whatever it takes to get that starting spot.
Coach, I'll do whatever you ask me. If it's providing a spark off the bench, great. If it's starting, even better.
Good answer. Now get out of here.
It appears that things are finally starting to look up for DeMarcus Flight, except for that James Harden situation, but that's light work. We'll deal with that later. But check this out.
I was in town with another one of my clients, Dante Exum, and had to see if the rumors were true. Guess they are. New digs. Look who's moving up in this world. I'm sure you already know Dante, the biggest player to come out of Australia since ever. He can run the point, move over to the two guard, whatever anybody needs. He's about to take the league by storm.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
And this is the man I was telling you about, Dante. Destined to be the biggest undrafted success in the history of the league. Ballin', making money, going places.
Maybe, but he's gonna have to go through me to get there.
Boy, you acting like that's a challenge.
Take it however you want. You see what I mean on the court.
fellas, let's keep it cordial. We're all in the same money-making family here.
So, this has a bit of a Jackson Ellis type of rivalry vibe to it. We'll see how that plays out.
Yo, so what's up? It's not every day that you in the hood.
Just wanted to drop a little knowledge your way. We're in the exclusive club. A lot of people think the NBA life is easy, but I know different. There are ups and downs. Pressures most people got no clue about. Wanted to make sure you were dealing okay.
Oh yeah, man, I'm good.
Hold up, bruh. Did he really forget our last conversation?
All right, because if I've learned anything, is that your work ethic and consistency is the most important thing in the NBA. As long as you're putting that work in every single day, you'll be fine.
Hold on, man. Nobody wants to hear all that extra stuff right now, talking about knowledge and conducting yourself as an NBA player and this and that. You and I have an unresolved issue, so we need to get that squared away first before you take on your mentoring role once again, because that doesn't even make sense to me right about now. Until James and I sit down and have this conversation like men, you never know what might happen. This situation might see me take a turn for the worse. So before I dive into this commentary for this game, I want to say what's going down, folks. It's your boy C23. We are back on the sticks once again with another NBA 2K15, my career episode. Now, in the last video, DeMarcus Flight was showing flashes of brilliance, and the magic continues in this one because I'm letting go buzzer beaters just past half court, dropping them in for the 28-29 score, and I'm really surprised that one dropped because we barely got enough time to get our full shot motion off, and looking back at the replay, we really didn't get into our shot motion. We kind of just chucked it up there with just enough time to spare to beat the shot clock, and we ended up cashing it in, so we'll take that. I don't know how many more buzzer beaters like that you guys are going to see from me, but when they happen, you got to savor the moment. That's why you guys saw so many replays of that, by the way. Getting back to the gameplay, they turn the ball over. We're off to the races, but my character slows up for some reason. Doesn't really matter because we pull up and knock down the jump shot, which puts us right back in the lead. So on my next possession, I decide to get my teammates involved a little bit and drop the pass down low to Jones, who gets an easy bucket and probably should be shooting a free throw at this point because that looked like it should have been an and one. Next play, the distribution continues, dropping it down low to Howard, gets an easy layup off of that, just trying to make it easier for my teammates. Now, I don't know what this is about, but why am I missing so many layups right now? And yes, on that shot, there was defensive pressure there, so maybe that's why I missed the shot. But I'm talking about just in general, on the Hall of Fame difficulty, it feels like I'm missing way more open layups than I did last year in 2K14. And of course, I say that as I just score a layup. But it's looking like this one may come down to the wire, folks. Just about 5 minutes and 30 seconds to go, 81-79. They're leaving me open for that 5-foot jump shot? Come on now. Do you not know I'm just about automatic from that range? Just like Dwight Howard is from underneath the basket, we could run those two plays all day long. So, time is starting to wind down a bit. I see an open lane to the basket and I attack. I go up strong, one-handed, flushing it down with the left hand. And I'm not sure why he went up left-handed though. Right-handed seemed like it was a better option at the time. But anyways, it's still 2 points and we'll take the score. And no, Horford is not making that. Let's go. Give me that board. A score here could almost put the game out of reach. I pass it over to Ariza. He elevates for the 8-foot jump shot and buries it in transition. Let's go. So we're moving things ahead a bit. 89-87 with 1:54. The ball's inbounded to me. And you know what I'm going to do. I'm going to work. I'm looking to be aggressive and staying on the attack. Going up strong with the left-handed layup. There was a little bit of contact there. I probably should have shot a free throw, but hey, we'll still take the score regardless. But why is my defense leaving men wide open for jump shots? So with the Elton Brand jumper, it's 91-89. I'm back on offense, backing down my opponent, but I face up and see a wide open lane to the basket. I take it and they foul me. Come on, bruh. And wait, hold on, man. Is dude's hair really like that? Does he really have that one bleach spot right there in the corner of his head? Will somebody please let me know, because if that's a fashion statement, somebody needs to drop him off at the nearest barbershop and get that cut off, because I don't know what that is. Anyways, we're getting back to the gameplay after knocking down my free throws. We got less than a minute to go, and I'm looking to just pull a dagger right here. They're leaving me so much space for the tray, so what do? I elevate and knock it down, and with that, we hold on for the W. We end up taking this one 100-89. It got a little bit more interesting than it should have been at the end, but we end up holding on and taking the W regardless. Taking a quick look at my stat line, wow, I shot exactly 50% on the night, 11 for 22, 28 points, 2 boards, and 5 assists. I also got the legendary work ethic badge. Apparently, I've shown the willingness to do whatever it takes to become a better player. I guess they just recognize the man that puts in his work on the court. Really can't argue with that. And I also got the hesitation stunner badge. I guess defenses are really getting freaked out by my hesitation moves. And if my moves are stunning them now, wait until I actually rank up in that category. It's gonna be a wrap. But anyway, folks, I'm gonna cut out here. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to click that thumbs up button. Also share this video as well. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. I'm signing off here, folks. I'll see you in the next one real soon.